Here's Troy Brown Jr.
Takes flight. That's how you go to the rim with authority.
You're watching Home Court Stories. I'm Deandra. I'm here with Troy Brown Jr. We're in Las Vegas at the court that he grew up on. How does it feel to be here?
It feels good. I mean, for me personally, it looks exactly the way I remember it, so it definitely gives me a good feeling. So yeah.
Has anything changed since you were here?
The only thing that changed, my elementary school over there, it's repainted. But other than that, this is exactly how I remember it. I haven't been here since middle school, and I just feel like very comfortable right now, like very relaxed, just because like this is where it all started, you know, like this is when, like, back when there were no dollar signs or anything like that. It was just straight basketball and just me out here with my headphones in with a jacket on, freezing at night, just shooting. So yeah.
When you were a kid, did you think about being in the NBA? Was that something that was on your mind or a hope that you had?
It was definitely a hope, but like it didn't really become like a real thing to me until I got to high school. Like I never like imagined being in the NBA. I always just pictured myself where I was at then and there and just kind of went with it. Like, I got to be the best player I can be now,
right,
type of thing. So.
Were there players that you looked up to growing up?
Definitely. Magic Johnson, my favorite player, like, of all time. Him and LeBron. Just that big guard, like, type of style of play. And, like, I feel like they paved the way for me to be as versatile as I am now. Penny Hardaway. Just guys like that, that are those big guards that, you know, people think are kind of unorthodox and have a different playing style. And I feel like that kind of is similar to how I play. So
when you were a kid playing here on this court, did you just shoot? Did you have, like, were you making up scenarios in your head? What was that like as a kid?
Yeah, I feel like for me personally, like the game winner, like, type of mentality, yeah. Like every shot I shot was like 3, 2, 1. I was definitely that kid for sure. So I would definitely say that. And then I just always imagined myself like playing in a real game. Like, you know, like, okay, like I'm in a game, like, oh, that's not gonna work in a real game. This will work, like, you
right.
know? So definitely that mentality for sure.
Okay,
yeah.
Cool. What is your favorite thing about the game of basketball?
I would say my favorite thing is definitely the fact that you can't perfect basketball. Like, you can't perfect it at all. You could be the greatest shooter in the world, but you'll never shoot 100%. Like, that's just what it is. So every day you have to keep on trying to get better.
All right, so we're gonna take some shots.
Yep, okay.
Do a little
cool
basketball
Let's
here.
Do it. Let's do
all
it.
Right. Well, you're gonna take some shots.
Oh, this ball kind of flat.
It's a little flat,
oh my
yeah.
God.
Straight shooting.
What up, fool?
Show them that wrist work.
Huh? You the one that need to get up here with the wrist work. Oh, my jacket kind of light.
What has it been like to watch him get to this point?
It's been awesome for me. Just yeah. because a person I have such a close relationship with, to see them succeed and do good in an area where they're passionate at, and see them reach a level where they've always aspired to reach.
Yeah.
It inspires you in a lot of ways to set out and do things that you want to do in life. So it's been awesome for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And how is it for you to have friends that you had as a kid now with this life that you got, and you have friends that you still had as a kid? What's that like?
It's definitely dope, because like you have people that have always been there for you. So you know everything that they're telling you is for your best interest. You know, it's harder
right.
to really take people that come in and out of your life very serious. And so
yeah.
you have somebody that literally you're up here and I could text them at 10, 11, 12, hey, I'm trying to go put up shots. And he's like, hey, I'll come rebound for you if you want it. Like, to have somebody reach out like that and
right.
like really take basketball as serious as you do, but they're not the ones even like really
right.
like trying to reach the goals that you are, it really definitely, it humbles you, you know?
Yeah.
Because it definitely makes it a lot better. And, you know, with that support, it definitely helps.
So, yeah. Have you ever lost a friend from a rough game of one-on-one?
No. not friends. I mean, family, definitely. You know, everybody in my family played basketball for a very long time. And so we go to the court. My dad would whoop us up, and then he'd take a light on us. And my older sister, Jada, would win and stuff like that. And I used to be so competitive
yeah.
that I took it so serious. And it was just like, I would get so mad, but I was only like 7, 8. Like, you know, but in my
yeah.
head, I'm like, I'm not the one out here working hard, like this and that. I need to be winning. And so it just motivated me even more. So then when I got to like 11 or 12, nobody wanted to play me anymore, you know? But like, those are the type of things that people don't really take into consideration. Like, then it was like, okay, now I'm not in the games no more. Now I'm trying to beat dad. So when I'm in here working, I'm thinking about beating dad, like, you know?
So yeah. you were wanting to win from the time you were little.
From
that,
the jump.
That competitive drive
from
is
the
there.
From the jump.
Yeah.
Because like, that's just how my dad is.
Right.
Like, I got that from him. Like, even when I was a kid, like, I used to, like, throw, like, temper tantrums and stuff when I didn't win because I was just that competitive. Like, I didn't care. Like, we could be playing, like, checkers. And if I lost, like, I'm mad. I don't want to talk to you. Like, that's just how I was, you know? So.
Yeah. Do you still feel that way when you play checkers?
For sure, but it's definitely a more, you know, calm and subtle, like, okay, you won, like, haha, like, all jokes and stuff, but in my head, I still be pissed off, I'm not gonna lie, so.
Yeah.
I'm not even gonna lie to you, like, so.
How would you describe Las Vegas basketball?
I would definitely say Las Vegas basketball is like a hidden gem. I feel like we definitely have a lot of talented players out of here, but just because of, like, the city being surrounded by the casinos and like sports betting and all that stuff, a lot of people don't really get the recognition they should. You know, we definitely have guys that have came in and out of the league and guys that were McDonald's All-American, Jordan Brand Classic that don't get the same recognition as guys from California and stuff like that. So
Yeah, it's interesting to see how much basketball is here. I never knew that.
Right. Yep. It's like until you come here and you see it, then you're like, oh, I didn't even know this little like community existed.
Yeah.
And like for it to be such a small portion with such talented guys, it's like, you know, like it goes unnoticed and it's pretty crazy, but.
Were you aware of that growing up?
For sure. That was always my motivation. Like, I got to make it out of here. Like, I have something to prove for my city, you know? Like growing up in Vegas, like we have so many dudes that it was like, if he played against somebody in California, like he was 10 times better than that guy, but it was just like publicity wise, nobody knew him.
Right.
So it was like nobody cared.
Yeah.
So yeah, that was definitely a big motivation for me, which is just kind of set that standard and like just try to stick in the league as long as I can and show people like, hey, it's possible. Like it is capable. Like just because you're from Las Vegas doesn't mean that you can't make it.
Troy, thank you for doing this. Thank you for your time. It's been great talking to you. And it's really cool to see, you know, where you started out. Just like there's kids here right now that maybe have dreams of being in the same place that you are, and you took that and you're playing in the league, and that's awesome.
So I appreciate that.
Thanks for sharing your story.
Yeah. Yep, thank you.
Stay right there. Don't smile. Okay. I got it.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah!
Oh.
Wow. Wow.
He cashed. He got the steal and the bucket.
Let me get that. He go. He's gonna come nowhere near this court after this.
I want no real smoke. He brought it down here.
We're just gonna be keeping up.